What happens when modern technology meets up with raw AMG power? Well, it's this, the 2023 Mercedes-AMG SL63. What's it like? Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. That's high time we drove another AMG on this channel, because the last one we drove was one of my race cars. And this is a road car, which is why, of course, AMGs exist. And this is a pretty cool thing. It's the all new SL, does have the big V8, makes glorious sounds and lots of power, but it is all new. And before we get into what it's like to drive, let's have a look at this new SL63 in a little more depth. Since this SL is all new, it's worth paying attention to what's going on mechanically. And for starters, this chassis is much stiffer than the old one. And on top of that, this new SL is a soft top only. As for the important bits, they start with AMG's 4-liter twin-scroll twin-turbo V8, makes 577 horsepower from 5,500 to 6,500 RPM, and 590 pounds of torque from 2,500 to 5,000 RPM. There are dynamic engine mounts, of course. Transmission is a 9-speed automatic with a wet multi-plate clutch instead of a torque converter. AMG has tuned the 4MATIC all-wheel drive, multi-link suspension in all four corners, adaptive dampers, and an active hydraulic anti-roll control system instead of traditional anti-roll bars, massive brakes, 390mm rotors with 6 piston calipers at the front, single piston at the rear with 360mm rotors, variable ratio, variable assist, 4-wheel steering, active aero at the back with 5 positions on the rear wing. There is the optional AMG aero package with more active aero at the front. As I mentioned, the roof is a soft top. It goes up and down in 15 seconds, up to 37 miles an hour. The interior is very tech forward with the latest MBUX. And if you take your SL63 to the track, there is standard data acquisition for track work, so you can improve your lap times. Oh, and it's now a 2+2. There's actually a back seat. I'm not sure who's going to use that. Wheels and tires are 20s or 21s. And did you know S stands for super and L stands for light? And curb weight of this 2023 SL63 is 4,300 pounds. From a driver interface standpoint, this is spot on. It is very much modern AMG, and maybe to a fault, which we'll get into a little bit later. I love the way I'm set up as a driver. Very, very comfortable. Lots of creature comforts in here as well, which I really wasn't expecting from an AMG. So it's got everything you want from the performance side as well as the creature comfort side. But the seating position, absolutely spot on, great relationship to the steering wheel and the pedals. Other than the flat bottom, love the shape and the size of the steering wheel, and love the way the controls are here. It's very much modern AMG, and really dig the way the controls are laid out. And one of the interesting things is, where do I do this? Let's do this. Oh, and check this out. We can tilt the screen if we want. I don't know if we need that extra little motor in here to tilt the screen, but of course you can adjust it in any position you like. Coincidentally, this is the hottest day of the week and the hottest day of the year so far. This is just incredible, but I am very comfortable. Got the ventilated seat on, do have the air conditioning on, but I'm very, very comfortable here. What I'd like maybe is a little bit more wind protection. I'm not sure if there is some kind of divider that sits back here, but I'm not sure. I'm sure some Mercedes expert can tell me all about that. But otherwise, lots of space for you and your passenger. This second row is really suited to small dogs and shopping bags. The trunk is actually a little bit more spacious than you'd expect. It's got a little bit more room underneath where the roof folds into. So it doesn't quite fit two carry-ons, but you can fit carry-on and a backpack and that sort of thing. And of course, you can use that rear seat for a little bit more storage if that's what you need. I do have to mention, this Burmester sound system is just incredible in this car. I'm absolutely loving every minute listening to it, at least when I'm not listening to that AMG V8. Ugh. Yeah, this thing is incredibly quick, but there is one thing that I will share in just a moment. Apparently this will do 0 to 60 in like 3 flat. Like, it's incredibly quick. Has to do with how the entire drivetrain is tuned, especially the all-wheel drive. This thing can put down power like there's no tomorrow. This is just incredible. But what is also interesting is that this AMG SL63 does give you a great sensation of speed. So you're never caught doing, you know, twice the speed limit. It actually communicates the sensation of speed, which is something I'm pleased about, because it's easy for a big car like this, a very high performance, powerful, heavy car like this, to sort of mute that feeling. But that's not the case at all. You've got a great sensation of speed, almost like you do in an MX-5. The 9-speed automatic just shifts incredibly smooth. They have dialed this transmission. If anything, there's maybe a couple of gears too many for my liking, but otherwise the transmission is fantastic, very flexible, and of course the engine is extremely flexible with the amount of power and torque that it makes. And does it ever sound fantastic? This is just a glorious motor, and this is really a special thing. I hope AMG keeps making these for a really long time, because this is a fantastic engine. What's funny is that you don't feel any intrusion of the all-wheel drive system. They have tuned that specifically for this car, and AMG has done their specific tuning to it, so you never feel like the all-wheel drive system is interfering as you would maybe a few years ago. This really feels more like a rear-wheel drive convertible than an all-wheel drive sort of grand tourer. In terms of handling, that's where this really shines. No, it's not as crisp and as sharp as the AMG GTR is, but that's not what this car is about. What this really is kind of a hot rod of a Grand Tourer, or hot rod open top Grand Tourer, and AMG kind of does that. There's a lot of attitude here. Certainly has to do with the way this puts down power and the way it sounds, but in terms of handling, it is remarkable. Given that it's about 4,300 pounds, the suspension has this thing incredibly dialed in. Part of that has to do with the sophistication of the dampers. That anti-roll control is incredible as well. The dampers do an excellent job, but that anti-roll control has a lot more flexibility than traditional anti-roll bars, because when we're driving along like this in a straight line, basically the system frees up roll, so you've got a lot more movement, a lot more control in the wheels, and that results in a more comfortable ride. The sophistication of the suspension allows it to have a complete range of character. So it does corner crisply, turns in crisply and sharp, and handles exceptionally well. And then when you want it to be comfortable, well, you switch the suspension over to comfort and it rides incredibly comfortably as well. It's a very flexible system, and the suspension is just incredible in this car. As well, brakes are incredible. The brakes have this astonishing ability to slow this car down. And these aren't the carbon ceramics. These are just the standard brakes. Yes, they're two-piece rotors, and that helps with heat dissipation and unsprung weight and all of that, but they stop this SL incredibly well. And on top of that, the brake pedal is very clear. Feel modulation control absolutely crystal clear with this brake pedal, which is unusual for a 2-ton car like this. That sort of never happens where you've got great braking, but this is just incredible in terms of a dynamic package. Oh, and I have to mention that there are a bunch of standard drive modes, and you can configure them, but the one I find incredibly funny is the one that says race, and we know that this is not a race car. How do you spec yours? Well, this is a fairly simple question to answer, but primarily it's going to come down to your personal choice. Base price in the US is $178,000 as tested. It's about $192,000 as you see it. Here in Canada, base price is $214,000 and as tested, about $240,000. When it comes to speccing yours, there are three things to consider. One is, do you want the carbon ceramics? Haven't tested them, can't comment. Number two is, do you want the AMG Aero package? So that's a little bit bit more active aero than it already has as standard equipment. So that's a question for you. And then the third is, how do you want yours to look? Do you want something as trendy as this paint or something a little bit more elegant? You have some interior color choices as well, and there's some minor interior color choices, but that is about it. The only two performance-minded options really are the carbon ceramics and the AMG aero package. And other than that, pick your colors and be happy with your Mercedes-AMG SL 63. My verdict, well, we often talk about fuel consumption at this point in the episode, but that's not what an AMG is all about, let alone when we have the 4-liter twin turbo V8 under the hood. It is just glorious. And the way I drive it, it's not that efficient. On the freeway, it's not too bad. It's relatively efficient and I don't mind it for that. That doesn't come to me as much of a surprise. But as for the rest of this SL63, love the way it drives. Very impressed with the technology, save for one thing. I would just love a manual switch inside the cockpit so I can open and close the roof easily. Other than that, I really don't have too many complaints. Really dig this SL63. If you're looking for something like this, you definitely owe it to yourself to get behind the wheel and test drive an SL63. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 Mercedes-AMG SL63. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this episode with your friends, especially those on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Mercedes-AMG SL63s.